welcome everybody in the way here.
Good morning. Okay, you're turning me up? Yes, okay. Everybody hear me? I was vesting and putting on the mic and it fell apart. And I was a little nervous about that, but I screwed it back together and put it on and it worked, so. Good morning, everyone. It's such a pleasure to see you. My name is Molly Roberts. I'm the canon for diocesan life and leadership here in the diocese for another month. And then, those of you who don't know, I have accepted a call to go serve as priest in charge at Church of the Redeemer in Midlothian, Virginia. So I'll be moving. It's nothing that you all did. It's that I really feel called to go back to parish ministry because I miss knowing a parish like Everett knows you. I can't wait to hear you. I know you've had a wonderful time. Those of you who are singing, the rest of us will enjoy it. And we will do communion. You'll be instructed where to go. Is that everything I need to say? Awesome. Is that what you said?
I'm going to give those extras.
Drink
the
peas. Maybe put four or five extras on top of that.
Okay, there's 20.
Thank you. Let me just say it now. Wow. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be your kingdom, now
and forever. Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have given your only Son to be for us a sacrifice for sin and also an example of godly life. Give us grace to receive thankfully the fruits of his redeeming work and to follow daily in the blessed steps of his most holy life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, maintain justice and do what is right, for soon my salvation will come and my deliverance be revealed. And the foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, to minister him, to love the name of the Lord and to be his servants, all who keep the Sabbath and do not profane it and hold fast my covenant, these I will bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. Thus says the Lord God, who gathers the outcasts of Israel, I will gather others to them besides those already gathered. The word of the Lord.
Oh,
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. I ask then, has God rejected his people? By no means. I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham, a member of the tribe of Benjamin. God has not rejected his people whom he foreknew. For the gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. Just as you were once disobedient to God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so they have now been disobedient in order that by the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God has imprisoned all in disobedience so that he may be merciful to all. The word of the Lord.
I'd like to add the welcome from St. Francis by the Sea to all of you. It's so good to look around and see people who are often here every year, and we should sign you up and give you a pledge card. This is a gospel that kicks up a bit of trouble, but then ends exactly right. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Jesus called the crowd to him and said to them, "Listen and understand. It is not what goes into the mouth that defiles a person, but it is what comes out of the mouth that defiles." Then the disciples approached him and said to him, "Do you know that the Pharisees took offense when they heard what you said?" He answered, "Every plant that my heavenly Father has not planted will be uprooted. Let them alone. They are blind guides of the blind. And if one blind person guides another, both will fall into a pit. But Peter said to him, explain that parable to us. He said, are you also still without understanding? Do you not see that whatever goes into the mouth enters the stomach and goes out into the sewer? But what comes out of the mouth proceeds from the heart, and this is what defiles. For out of the heart come evil intentions, murder, adultery, fornication, theft, false witness, slander. These are what defile a person, but to eat with unwashed hands does not defile. Jesus left that place and went into the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then, a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, have mercy on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon. But he did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, send her away, for she keeps shouting after us. He answered, I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. But she came and knelt before him, saying, Lord, help me. He answered, it is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs. She said, yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered her, woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish. And her daughter was healed instantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I speak to you this morning with love for Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Please be seated. Just very quickly, David and Kevin, my new church has an opening for an organist choir master. That's true. If any of you feel like, either of you feel like Midlothian would be a good place, talk to me. Now, many of you don't know me at all. Some of you know me a little. But so let me say this much to you. I'm not necessarily an easy person. I have my opinions, and I will state them. I try and do so diplomatically, but I don't always manage that. And this has been my whole life. When I was a senior in high school, so 17, very much the maturity and faith of a 17-year-old, I went to an Episcopal high school, and had, since I was in sixth grade, so every year we'd had some class in religion, but I was really excited about the one in our senior year because it was religions of man. We were going to study the other religions in addition to Christianity, and I thought that would be fascinating. Our professor was a visiting professor. He was an Episcopal priest. I have no idea what his name was. I can sort of picture him. But I was ready to take anything he said, because after all, he was a well-educated Episcopal priest. He knew what he was talking about. Now, looking back on it, I realize that he talked about the other religions of the world with disrespect. And I probably absorbed some of that. It took me a while to get past that. But one day in class, about 2 weeks well, 12 days before graduation. You know, as you're a senior, you count those things. 12 days before graduation, he assigned a full term paper to the class. None of us were happy about that. We grumbled a lot. I grumbled a lot. And he heard me, but he didn't say anything. Just to the class in general, this is what's happening. Take care of it. Then he went on to remind us of a parable. Now, I really can't remember which parable it was, but he read the parable to us and gave his interpretation. What I remember is it was not the interpretation that I had been taught before. It was very different than the interpretation I knew. And so I raised my hand and said, "Father so-and-so, I thought the meaning of that parable was..." Well, apparently that was a bridge too far for him. And he said, and I quote, "Miss Roberts, your tears will not move me." 12 days from graduation, folks. 17. I said, "I wouldn't cry over you if you were the last person on earth," and picked up my books and left. Now, what I did was I went to the assistant headmaster, Father Benton Ellis, who is an amazing priest, the chemistry teacher, assistant headmaster, and a good family friend. And I poured out my heart about this bad interpretation of this parable and the fact that we had a new term paper and it was just not fair and, you know, 17 angst. And he laughed and said, "Don't worry about it. You don't have to go back to that class. I'll finish up the class with you." "Well, thank you, Father Ellis." And he said, "But I want to tell you that today the Lord delights in you." And I thought he meant, you know, just like every day the Lord delights in me. And he said, "No, today the Lord especially delights in you, because you have engaged with him through the scripture." I had been forced to think about the scripture in a different way and engage in that thought process. And when I did that, I was engaging with the Lord. And that is when I learned that it is important not to be simply a receptacle and passive in your faith. It is important to engage in it, to be a partner in it. Now, as we have heard today, we have lots of people engaging with the Lord. In fact, it was Augustine who said, "Those who sing pray twice." I think you're getting more than two in there. Y'all are doing great. I suspect that all of us in this room are fairly consistent in engaging with our faith. We probably all pray on a regular basis, however regular works for you. You're in church, you're listening to the music and to the words and to me. So you're engaging, not completely passive, and that's great. But I also suspect that for some of you, that has become fairly routine, fairly rote. It's just what you do. So what I would like you to do, what I challenge you to do, is exactly what all of these singers have done in these past few days. Take up the engagement with your faith and your relationship with the Lord to a new and different level. Experience that faith, that relationship, in a new and different way. And my guess is that it will be powerful for you. I want to be clear. The Lord delights in you. The Lord created you just as you are and loves you just as you are and walks with you and delights in you. But the Lord invites the engagement. As our gospel story told us today, the woman argued with Jesus, argued with him. It's one of my favorite lessons out of the Bible because it shows that, in fact, you can engage with the Lord in a different way. You're not required to just be passive. You can state your case. And God will listen to you. Sure, sometimes he's going to say, no, you've got that wrong. But he will listen to you. Couldn't you feel it when you heard that gospel being read? And Everett, you did a marvelous job. Thank you for that. Couldn't you hear Jesus delighting in that woman? Your faith is so strong, he said to her. The Lord delights in all of us, just as we are. But he invites us into relationship that is a full relationship. So just like all relationships, sometimes they get a little stale. We don't pay enough attention. We just do what we do out of habit. This week, I urge you to look at your habits and figure out something new, something different. Maybe it's something you just haven't done in a while. Or maybe it's something completely out of the blue. I don't know. Each of us has our own patterns. But surprise the Lord. Engage with him in a new and different way. I believe that you will feel his delight. Standing, let us together affirm our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God.
The prayers of the people. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, especially Libby Stedham, Laura Powell, Eleanor R., Randolph, Carrie, Paulette, Charlotte, Doug and Kathy, Bob S., Kevin Barnes, Marion, Rusty, Dottie, Carol, Cheryl, Maria, Al Hines, Fran P., Gail, Jack and Juan Lon family, Betty Hart, Danner family, Glenn Johnson, Joel Clark, Dave and family, Zane and family, Tommy, Jana and Corey, Lee Worth, Ann Urquhart, the people of Maui and Hawaii, Trinity Episcopal Church by the Sea, Hiei, Hawaii, St. John's Episcopal Church, Kula, Hawaii, Holy Innocents Episcopal Church, Lahaina, Hawaii. Are there others? That they may be delivered from their distress. Give to the departed eternal rest.
Let life perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also share your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will, walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
This is often the time of announcements. Are there announcements that somebody needs to make? Hearing none. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offerings into his courts with praise and thanksgiving.
Yeah. what?
Well, I'm happy to do it. I just didn't know. I think I'll let them sing first. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on the first day of the week overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection, opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and dark angels and with all the company of heaven who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Thank you.
thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with all your saints we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Let us pray. God of abundance, you have fed us with bread and life, and the cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ in one another. You have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world, and redeem forever through his life, Christ our Savior. Amen. Okay, you may do what you've been dying to do. Just a joy. Let us pray. O God, whom saints and angels delight to worship in heaven, be ever present with your servants who seek through music to perfect the praises offered by your people on earth. and grant to them even now glimpses of your beauty, and make them worthy at length to behold it unveiled forevermore. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
I say with firm faith this morning that God has been delighted. May you go forth this week and work at delighting him again and again. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you now and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Being respectful to them.